So, me and Gab were watching Netflix the other night, flicked on the Taylor Swift documentary, Miss Americana, never seen it before, absolutely loved it. I'm fascinated with all these artists who are at the absolute top of their game. I always wonder what it would be like if you were just dropped into that studio scenario with them. You know, what could you bring to the table with the likes of Miley Cyrus, Taylor Swift, Stevie Nicks? So in my experience, being in a band, songwriting, the music always came first, and then our singer would come in, write the vocals, melodies, finish the song. I've never had to write a song before to a completely finished vocal. Challenge accepted. I guess you could say that I've been watching Miley Cyrus's career at a distance, but I absolutely love her. I think she's got such an incredible voice and a totally badass image. Recently, she's been creeping in covers by Pink Floyd, Led Zeppelin, these incredibly iconic rock bands. And she says to the fans, I'll play a couple for you and a couple for me. She's got such a rich, raspy, powerful voice, and it's just perfect for rock music. So I went on a little bit of a YouTube hunt to find a Miley Cyrus a cappella, studio vocal, no music, and it had to be a song of hers that I'd never heard before. One that I'd missed, according to Gab. It's called Midnight Sky. It's a little bit cheeky of me, but I needed to know. So any problems, Miley, give me a call. Get you a couple of pints at the local pub. But in the meantime, let's check out my version of Midnight Sky.
We're at the computer, glasses are on,
I'm going to listen to Miley's original for the first time. This is going to be really weird. Let's check it out. Very Fleetwood Mac. I like it. Super Stevie. It's interesting because I went super creepy and dark with that second verse. It's like Fleetwood Mac collaborated with the people who wrote the Stranger Things theme tune and then said, let's get Miley. I love it. You should know. I know all the lyrics now. Better than my break. I really didn't like how all the reverb and effects came off on the vocal for that bit, but it makes sense now. It goes like super wet to super dry. And I was like, what? Obviously that suits what's going on in this song, so I just copied it onto a second channel here, and I think I just like cut it and added a little bit of a reverb spill on it, so it wasn't as drastically dry. If that makes, you can hear it spilling off. I've got some way to go in the engineering department, but my ideas are there. I think that might be my favourite drum and bass mix I've ever heard. There's something so, I don't know how to describe it. It sounds spherical. It's hitting me in all of my throats, all of them. It's really interesting that I wanted to put in these staccato 80s synth lines. With this little pad. And then in the chorus. Similar kind of thing. What a tune. I absolutely loved that. And I've loved working on this video. I started it on Monday, finished it Tuesday evening, then I've been editing the video. I hope you enjoyed it. I wanted to do something different. I think it's really important to chuck yourself outside your little comfort zone and try new things. And I've been really inspired and I came up with loads of different ideas. I was playing around with synths. Writing drums out, and I've got better just from experimenting with this video for you guys. So don't forget to smash the like button, please. If everyone who watched liked, I'd be like Mr. Beast, Mr. East. That's what they're gonna start calling me. What a terrible, terrible joke. Okay, subscribe, hit the bell. I'm gonna go now and edit this bit into the video that you're watching. It's like, it's all out of sync. Anyway, have a good weekend. Peace.